Hello, I'll show you today the way that I'm growing my pepper. And here I saved the seeds from last year that from the pepper that I gathered in my garden. But if you don't have the seeds, no problem. You can buy them from the store, or you can just go and buy the best pepper that you like it from the store and just retrieve the seeds. And you'll get the seeds that you can plant them for the year. So here I have a container with soil, and I have the holes at the bottom of it for the drainage. And here I purchased the soil from the store. This is from this year. Because for the seedlings, you need to have a fluffy soil. You cannot use the soil from the previous year from the garden because it's too heavy and the roots are not going to grow very nice through the soil. So here I'm using this topsoil, and I will just place the seeds here, spread them on the surface. You don't have to pay attention now to the density of those, because later you can just pull out the ones that you don't want them or are too many on one spot. Just gently spread them. And try to make it a little bit like kind of even on the soil. The same thing, this is the sweet pepper. Also, you have to do this, or you can do this with hot pepper. So after I spread the seeds on the soil, I'm going to cover them gently. You don't have to use too much soil because they are very small. So it's just to cover them, not to make it very thick on top. So after I will cover them here, I will just spread them with water and let them in a dry, kind of not very hot place. They don't have to be exposed to the sun at this point because they haven't grown yet. So you can just place them on a shelf or anywhere else where you have, and let them there to germinate. So I will just spread the water. And if you don't have this type of spray, doesn't matter, you can use any other kind. It just needs to be moist. And keep the soil moist for the coming days. You can cover here a little bit, the one that is exposed. And just leave them to germinate. Now, here, I got already the ones that I've planted them like 2 weeks ago, and as you can see, they've grown very nice. This one is 3 weeks old, and if you don't have containers, you can grow them in the way that I'm doing it here. But if you do have the containers, you can just place one by one individual in the container, and they will grow in this way. So it will be probably easier for you to just plant them outside in the garden. Now, to make sure that they will grow healthy, by the time that they will grow too many at one point, like a bunch of them, just try to grab the ones that they are weak or too small, or you don't like them, and just make sure that you'll have only the plants that they will be very strong, like very healthy, strong ones. So if there are too many on one spot, just just pull one and let the rest of them to grow in very healthy and give them space. You don't have to, like here, you see, you can just pull this one and leave the other one. Make it very gently because the roots, of course, are very fragile and you don't want to break them. So after you'll have a good weather outside, when at night the temperature doesn't go below 0 degrees Celsius, you can just start to plant them. To feed them during this period of time, You can use like a tea, means it's like a liquid that you can obtain it from the leftover tea bags or coffee grinds, or if you boil potatoes or pasta or any other veggies, save the water, don't throw it away, mix together and you will get like a strong composition out of it. So this one you can mix it with plain water, so you can use 1 cup of this composition as a tea for 2 cups of tap water. So that is going to feed them over this period of time, and the results will be absolutely so amazing. So after I will have a good weather in my garden, I will show you the way that I'm going to plant them. But at this moment, you can just grow them inside the house. So that is the absolute basic way to grow those plants. So I hope that you will enjoy doing it. I hope that was an inspiration for you, this video, and I hope that you are safe and happy. Thank you so much for watching this video. I wish a very good day. Goodbye.